The Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs started the probe by interfacing with the Tororo District woman MP Sarah Opendi, who petitioned Parliament over the matter. Opendi noted that residents of her district who expressed interest in joining the army had been left out in favour of non-residents who were ferried from other areas.
There are people who fainted. They had paid money, taken actually another one, even followed, and they said, okay, we didn't take you, follow us to Palisa. And when he went to Palisa, no, along the way as they were going, I'm told they were going to Palisa, he was boarded off from the plane, from the truck, and told to go back home. He took 4 days and didn't get out of the house. So this entire UPDF recruitment exercise needs to be changed.
She accused the UPDF recruitment officers of hiding information about the 120 recruits from Tororo District from the area leaders.
Slots. Unfortunately, the recruitment exercise went on and our people, the leaders, were not allowed to verify the people who had been picked. And even the list upon completion of the exercise was not given to the leaders up to now. We don't know who these people are.
Opendi underscored the need to change the whole process, saying the recruitment team was taking on less important issues like sexual transmitted infections, dental issues, among others.
If we check those officers who are recruiting, are they themselves healthy? They might be having other diseases, but they are in the UPDF. So why do you throw out people just because they have some STD, as if that cannot be cured?
Medical, you have one gap in your dental formula. You have a gap. Yes. Then there are two girls. You have ever procured an abortion. Go out. You have ever procured an abortion. So they kept eliminating them. There's a boy who had a baluku. A baluku, these have a conjo. But he's a born of Iganga. The mother is married there. The father has stayed there for long. So when a baluku came, they were bouncing. But the ID was reading Nakalama. Nakalama is in Iganga. So we said it's not a mistake for him, a Mukonjo, to be born in Iganga. When he was about to cross the bar, again, they said the pass slip was a forgery. But the thing was genuine. They said this one was a little soft than the others. Because he had all, you see, they have changed the pass slips from U on the index somewhere. Now it is O. Again, they are telling they are forged until we picked some with the similar pass slips.
Evelyn Chemtai, the Bukoh District Woman MP, also testified before the committee, saying that the recruitment officers ignore the cultural aspects of different communities, adding that among the Sabinyi, lower teeth are removed.
And for us in our culture, actually, we remove the lower teeth, which is not a problem. It's beauty. So we don't expect to be victimized for doing that. And we also have a culture where people have scars just for decoration. And most of the people, especially from Amudat, tattoos, actually, the other traditional tattoos, most people from Amudat were not recruited. I think not even a single one, because most of them had tattoos, they had scars, and it also depends on the environments where we live.
MPs on the committee who reacted to the presentations by the petitioners reported issues of forged recommendation letters, bribery, and lack of cooperation with the leaders of communities where the applicants came from.
They would only reconsider those LOCs letters and the districts, GISOs and DISOs, at the time of verification. But at the end of the day, you would find, like in one district, or in one recruitment center, maybe they wanted 50, and you find like 40 are from one district.
Well, even if the ID is from LC1, does that make you a GA in Kotido? I think those are things that we need to get to. But I'm just wondering whether it is possible for the committee to request the actual people who are doing the recruitment to be here. Because to bring somebody here is to bring a general to come and begin talking about classified like somebody referred to.
The committee chaired by the vice chairperson Melton Muoma has resolved to visit Kawaweta Training School and interact with the recent recruits.
Because if we ask somebody from Tororo, we can say, can we sample? They are here. You ask which village, who is the LC3 chairperson? They will stammer when we visit the training school. I think as we progress with the investigation, we should also provide for that.
The Minister of Defense is expected to appear before the Committee of Defense and Internal Affairs over the matter. Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.